love my channel and would like to show your support, please click on the link below this video and become the patron of the Ushanka Show. For as little as $1, you can help us grow and create the new interesting videos about the life in Soviet Union.
Hello, comrades, and welcome back to Ushanka Show. Today I would like to touch one more time the topic of religion in Soviet Union and how the Soviet government was fighting the religion. And specifically, I would like to talk about one interesting story about the church in Moscow. As I mentioned in my previous video, during the Soviet regime, especially in the beginning, during the Stalin rule, thousands and thousands of churches were destroyed or repurposed. And one church has a quite an interesting history, so today we'll talk about it. There is a beautiful church in Moscow, the capital of Russia. It's called the Cathedral of Christ the Savior, which is the tallest Orthodox Christian church in the world at 338 feet. Beautiful church, but you'll never guess if you didn't know the history of this church that this cathedral disappeared for over 60 years and now he's back at its glory in the dominating downtown Moscow, but for over 60 years it wasn't there. So what actually happened? The idea of this church started under Tsar Alexander I right after the War of 1812 when France attacked Russia. And it was a really horrible war for both sides. If you remember the history, Napoleon took Moscow. Then he had to abandon Moscow and struggle through the winter back to Europe. And he lost almost all his army. Of course, Russians lost a lot of people too, soldiers and officers. So it was decided to build a beautiful church and dedicate it to the fallen soldiers and officers that perished in the War of 1812 and also other wars. There were several designs and interesting moment that the church design actually was one from a 20-year-old Carl Wittberg, who even wasn't actually architect. He was Mason and by religion he was Lutheran. So in order to get his design accepted, like the Tsar Alexander I liked that the best, he had to get baptized into Russian Orthodox Church, and only after that he got accepted. As I said, it was a mega project, and especially considering it's 1800s, the total cost was 16 million rubles. It's even hard to say how much money in modern cash, but it's probably pushing billions. So 16 million rubles, that's what the government paid. Plus, there were a lot of donations from regular people and from tradesmen and other people. It was quite a different design, definitely not the classical look of the Russian churches. And construction took more than 40 years, from 1839 until 1883. At that time, a lot of things changed, including the Tsar. So the construction started under Alexander I and continued when Nikolai I became a Tsar in 1825. So when Nikolai I became a Tsar, the construction was stopped. Apparently, Carl Wittberg was a good, talented person to create this beautiful design, but he wasn't really good about running the project. There was a huge overspending, and he got arrested and sent to Siberia for overspending the money, around 1 million rubles. And in the same time, Nikolai I, he was a more like traditional Russian Tsar, so he didn't like the design, and so it was canceled. And then the new design was created, and it was more in like Russian Byzantine style. So there was a massive tall church, looking more as standard Russian churches. And since 1883, it was in service. When revolution happened in 1917 and the Soviet government separated the church from the state, the church financing stopped also, but they managed to get the financing and support the church asking people for donations. So since 1917 till 1930s, church was operated like normal churches do now, just based on people donations. A small interesting detail, during the construction in 1830s, they, besides changing design, they also changed the location where the church supposed to be, and they took down, in order to clear the space, there was a female monastery called Alexeyevsky Zhensky Monastery, and the lady who ran that monastery, she was really upset, and apparently she put a bad omen on the builders, and she predicted that this place will be empty, which is quite bizarre if, you know, thinking about what happened in the end of this church. So this lady actually put the bad omen on the church, and bad things happened in 1931. In July of 1931, Soviet government made a decision to build this new monumental Dom Sovetov, which is like the House of Soviets. So Soviet, it's like a government of Soviet Union, you know, we call Soviet Union, so it's a union of Soviets. And Soviets is like the when people gather together and discuss things, so they, it's a Soviet. So they decided to build this new monumental Dvorets Sovetov, and location was chosen right where the Cathedral of Christ the Savior was located. And of course, during that time, no one cared about the opinion of people, opinion of church. So they decided to destroy the church and clear up the space for this new massive building. For several months, they were trying to take it apart. But since it was a huge building, it was taken forever. So on December 5th, 1931, they did a controlled demolition. Actually, two of those, because first one didn't do much damage, and only after second one, they managed it to collapse. And construction began in 1937 for the Dvorets Sovetov, actually not Dom Sovetov, Dvorets, the palace of the Soviets, began in 1937. Well, I hope you enjoy my show. As always, don't forget to put likes under this video, share with your friends, and we'll talk to you soon. Goodbye.